Describe yourself in 5 words.
What was I thinking? I didn't even like look, I didn't get answers prepared. 5 words, oh boy. That's tough.
My name is Allie Cavanaugh and I was born in St. Louis, Missouri. When I paint, it's that same sort of thing. It's not a, I don't use the words. It's very hard for me to come up with words to describe it. I know what it is when I see it and I feel it and all that, but the words aren't there. Well, we decided to move to St. Genevieve, Missouri, and St. Genevieve, it's about 45 minutes away from where I graduated from high school. And we would come here on field trips, and it's such a neat little town with all sorts of historic homes, and it's, you know, only like 4,500 people in the town, and it's very small. But a lot of young families, and it's just quiet, and it's just a quaint little town. And we moved here, that's been almost 4 years ago, and we just love it. We absolutely love it. My process that now is taking me about, it takes me about 2 weeks to do one painting. And my paintings are not real large. I mean, my biggest paintings are 30 inches by 30 inches. A lot of times, when I encounter someone and they inspire, I see a painting. I arrange the photo shoot, because it's very, very seldom that I can stop at that moment and do, you know, photographs and sketches and get it all planned at that. So I usually have to recreate what that moment that first inspired me. So I start out by getting a panel and drawing it out, and I just layer just color after color after color. And a lot of times, like the skin tone in my figures, what that will have sometimes 50 layers of color. You know, it's like, it's sort of iridescent, but it takes so much patience to get that paint to go on the right way. And the panel, although the surface is just this incredible surface that's really durable, this kaolin clay, it's really like strong and forgiving, and it's just a great surface. It's also, you know, very delicate, and you have to have like the most delicate of touch. And so, you know, I can work and work and work and get all those layers on, and then that last layer just destroys it, and I have to strip everything off. And it can be very tedious. It takes a lot of patience. Then after the painting's done, then I seal it and I take it down. I have a studio in my basement that's like my shipping and seal it. That's where I seal the work, finish all the edges of the paintings, put the hanging wire on, all that stuff, and then I box everything up down in my basement studio, and I ship it off. That's start to finish. I started out just saying watercolor, and everyone, just calling them watercolor. And the thing is that every time I said that, people would get really confused. Most everyone that I've ever encountered, when they hear watercolor, they think of a loose, watery, you know, technique on the textured paper. And it just wasn't the right description for it, because even though, yes, I'm using watercolor on clay, it looks so much more like a fresco. And so I just started saying fresco, modern frescoes, but the plaster with the watercolor on it, just, it looks the most, that's the most accurate description that I could come up with to describe it. And when I started calling them frescoes, it made sense to people, like, oh, okay, that makes sense. I think that children influence my work mainly in the way that I have the kids in my space all the time. They're in my studio. They're in my home. I mean, my daughter is now 16, and then I have an 8-year-old son and almost a 2-year-old son. And so the kids bring so much energy into the home.
Okay.
Are always doing things that inspire me. They're always saying things that inspire me. Their perspective is so different from an adult perspective, and so that really, you know, makes me think about things differently. And also, I think one of the assets to having children is that they require so much time, and so that time that they take up, you know, as far as just caring for them, it makes me really use the time that I have to work, like, even more wisely. So I'm more organized with my time. The children force me to be more organized with my time.
She saw that I would be a great model whenever I looked at myself, and I just thought of myself as a little disgusting bald girl, but she saw something in me, and after the paintings, I was able to see what she saw, which was beauty. So anyways, I'm really glad that Allie had painted me, and I'm really thankful for what she did.
But when I first saw Millie, I saw her face on a coffee can collection here in town. We had just moved to St. Genevieve a few years back, and everywhere I went, the grocery store, the gas station, I saw this coffee can sitting there, and this beautiful blonde girl, 15 years old, has this terrible, aggressive, rare cancer.
I did not think of myself as a work of art, especially with being bald, and not just bald, no eyebrows or eyelashes. I didn't really feel the prettiest. So I was very surprised, but I was also extremely excited that someone as talented as Allie would want to paint me.
When I saw her, I was just like, it took my breath away because she was just so unbelievably beautiful, and here she's battling cancer.
The only issue was that I just didn't feel good. Like, I felt so sick, and whenever you're sick, you don't really want to do much, even if it's just posing for a picture.
She just had this presence that was so amazing, and so I just fell in love with her instantly and had to paint her. And
anyways, it turns out she actually kind of knew my mom and dad.
And she said yes, and so she let me come in and photograph her, and I did 2 photo shoots. So that was just a beautiful experience.
I think it's just extremely cool that she can take what she sees and like portray it in the paintings. That way the world can see how she sees things.
Mm-hmm.